Hi everyone, I'm Vic. I wanted to talk about the Elgato Prompter. I'm very excited about these features and I hope you are too. Now, setting up the prompter wasn't too challenging and it's making these videos I make for you very easy to stay on track. Well, let's get to it, y'all. All right, so as you can see, this is the prompter. And what I'm going to do is actually turn on my face cam so you can see all of the stuff that I'm pressing. Now, I want you to see it in action. And as you can see, everything is moving. I'm actually going to get up and I'm going to display the setup. I have it on a flex arm. A mic arm. But the cool thing is, you get to see everything in action real time. And if I use my dials here, right, I could do some really cool stuff. Now I'm demoing this for you because I want you to see so many things that are going to happen here that I'm going to talk about. This is pretty cool. And I'm excited to show you all this because I think this will probably help you decide if this is something that you want to do. Now, I am looking at the prompter as I'm showing you, but because I'm showing you real time what's happening using the Epic Cam with my phone, you're able to see, well, pretty much my script, right? It's pretty cool. But we're going to go ahead and jump into the software element of it. And we honestly, since you've seen pretty much what I'm doing with the dials here, like, you know, hopping from different modes. We're going to actually talk about that in the software. All right, so let's go ahead and open up Camera Hub because that's going to be the hub of everything and where everything starts when it comes to setting up. So here's my entire script. And yes, you will be writing a script. The script is basically going to help you stay on track, as I had mentioned before. Not only that, you're also giving your camera full eye contact. Now, this is unscripted, what I'm saying, so don't follow the script too literally. I mean, you still want to be you when it, at the end of the day when people are coming to see your video. But the cool thing is it's actually going to show everything for you. You're seeing how it's highlighted here. Well, as it's playing, it's highlighting where you are in your script, which I think is really awesome. So we're going to stop our script real quick here, because I can always come back to it. And we're going to talk about the modes. This is display. This is basically going to be something that you set up to use as a secondary display. So if I wanted to launch software, I would actually launch software directly in the display because you would set it up in your display settings. And that is going to be system display. And you're going to see that you can configure it wherever you want. And yeah, I am using an ultra wide. You're only getting just a portion of the screen. You don't need to see everything else going on my screen, but, you know, this is what it comes down to. This is the prompter and this is my ultra wide. So I can extend these displays. I could show one, I could duplicate them if I want. There's no need to duplicate unless you're doing like a dual PC setup. And this is just treated like a secondary monitor. Basically, this is the display. It's going upwards to show you script and everything that you're basically rolling through, but you can also use it as a secondary monitor, for example, like your Discord, or, you know, if you're watching a show while you're gaming, or, you know, you're watching a YouTube channel, or, you know, surfing the web, or, you know, you're needing a second screen for whatever need you need. It works, right? Like, I was worried as an ultra wide user, like, how is this going to work for me? But it actually turned out to be a godsend, so it's very handy. All right, now that's display mode. You can change the brightness of the display. You can actually change the opacity of the display, but the opacity is mainly solely for when you have text on your screen. Now, as we saw, a text feature is actually going to be when it comes to using your script, which we will get back to here in a moment. Now, there is going to be chat, and chat, basically, you set up your profile, whatever Twitch channel that you want to connect to, and this is basically going to ask you the Twitch channel, and you can put the title of optional. So if I wanted to do the Twitch channel, for example, on mine, and I put me, I could save that and it'll literally tell you what it is. If you don't want a title, you could do that and it'll just put the username of your Twitch channel or whoever's Twitch channel's chat that you're keeping an eye on. Personally, I would have it on mine. Now, I would like to see more with this particular feature, and I'm actually going to jump back to my script for this. And we're going to minimize the prompter real quick here as far as like Camera Hub. Honestly, I don't even need Camera Hub open anymore because we're going to actually talk about using it in Stream Deck. Speaking of which, here we go. That should be the right one. And we should be able to switch over to our Stream Deck Plus. All right, so there are going to be some dial features for the prompter, and then there are going to be some key features for the prompter. So let's start about the keys first, because I want to save the dials for last, as you saw me scrolling and doing everything with them. So when it comes to the prompter has quite a few different options, and we're going to cover that here. All right, so I'm going to actually pause my script for a moment and we're going to actually start talking about the software. Well, Stream Deck software integrated with Camera Hub. Now, you do have to download the plugin. I will post it from the marketplace so that way you download the correct plugin to use the prompter plugin with your Stream Deck. Personally, I would recommend getting a Stream Deck Plus if possible, if you're looking for a Stream Deck hardware, because you unlock Stream Deck and Wavelink software. Along with using it simultaneously with Camera Hub for whatever camera you might have with Elgato, whether it's a Facecam, Epic Cam, Facecam Pro. I do want to mention with Epic Cam, you do need to install iTunes in order to use it. It is only compatible with iOS right now, so definitely install iTunes and you're able to use Epic Cam. Now, as far as for the Stream Deck Plus, the benefits of using a Stream Deck Plus is the dials. Like, that is 100%. You get a touch swipe bar right here. You get to turn the dials right here. And then obviously have 8 keys that you can customize. Now, you can always add more pages. So if you're running out of buttons, you get an additional 8 for each page that you add. On top of that, you get an additional 4 dials. And then you get to see what's going on here with the dials. Now, I only need one page for demo purposes for the prompter. I feel like the prompter has enough options as it is. So we're going to start with the keys first. Now, there is going to be prompter control. Now, this is going to be pause and play when it comes to your script. And then there is going to be prompter mode. There's only 3 modes currently right now. So there's chat. And I'm only dragging and dropping for a reason so I can do it for demo purposes. There is going to be display. We'll move these up here. And then there is going to be text. Text is actually going to switch to your script, which is why it has the green check mark currently. Now, if I were to switch to display, then it's going to switch the green mark to display. And if I'm switching to my chat, it's going to take me to chat being check marked. Now I need to get back to the script. And I'm just going to let that roll for a minute. And then there's going to be the appearance. Now, the appearance has many different features. From font size, you get to change the size. Honestly, if you're going to do a font size kind of thing, oh yeah, silly me. I would recommend for appearance, font size, that you should probably do it with a dial because it will make it bigger or smaller. And you know what? I can probably show you that with Epic Cam here. Let me open that up real quick here, y'all. All right, so we set up the font size, and the font size will do this. It'll get bigger, it'll get smaller. And that's for people who are like myself, who are like squinting, like, oh, I can't read that, but now we can. So I think that's a really amazing feature, especially when it comes to people who are struggling to see something when it comes to their script, or even their chat. Personally, I think I might make this a little bit bigger now. All right. I know I'm like multitasking here with the handheld camera and then my face cam, which I have set up right here. And then, you know, obviously the prompters. So it's just juggling right now. All right. Let's go ahead and continue because there's more. Okay. So there are different appearances, right? So we're going to talk about each one. There is horizontal margin. So you can change it to where the prompter puts everything horizontal. And then there's going to be there is going to be vertical margin. So it moves the text, whether it's horizontal or vertical. Honestly, for me, it doesn't really make a difference if I'm having it horizontal or vertical. I'm content with out of the box because it's been working for me. Now, there is more appearances, and we're going to obviously delete those two so we have more. There's opacity. So you can set this or you can adjust it. Personally, if you're going to do opacity, I wouldn't do it here. I would not use the appearance here for opacity. Opacity, I would put here. And here's why. And again, I'm gonna get this ready for you all. All right, y'all can see it. I'm gonna be turning the opacity that we just set up, and it makes the screen darker. That way you can read the text clearly, and you're not gonna really see your camera if you set it up properly. So that way you're able to focus primarily on the text without feeling overwhelmed that there's a camera in front of you, which I think is an amazing thing for people who are extremely camera shy. I used to be. And I think that if this tool was available when I was first starting my journey, I probably would feel more at ease in front of a camera. It's almost like nobody's there, but you know there's a camera there, but you're more focused on the text. And I love that. It's those little details. I really do love it. Now, there is one more prompter appearance that we're going to talk about, and it's going to be line spacing. Oh, wait, I chose the wrong option here. Silly me. Now, the reason why I'm putting it in the key is because you can set it. And when you do the line spacing and you set it, it's going to fix it. But if you're wanting to change that, you can actually drop it into a dial, go down to line spacing, and adjust it. So it'll either condense or expand the line spacing. And we're going to actually demo that again. So let me get the Epic Cam back out. And I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. So as you can see, it's spacing out the lines or it's condensing them. And I think that's a really cool feature. Granted, I probably will not be using the line spacing because if you make your text readable and you know you're doing things, I want to say in a way where it's at your pace, then you're not going to really need to worry about line spacing unless like you're writing a novel or something and then you're reading it. Now, there are more features and we're going to talk about scrolling. Now, the reason why I'm putting scrolling right here, again, we're going to demo it. Because scrolling on the speed, you get to adjust it, as you can see with the face cam and the software as I'm turning the dial, you get to do that. Now, if I hit play, right, you're going to see it in action. And if I wanted to go, oh, wait, I'm changing the opacity. That's not what I was trying to do. Here we go. So if I wanted to go faster, right, you could see my entire script that I wrote out. And you should probably proofread before you actually do your script so you don't actually say a typo. But you could slow it down really slow, or you can go super fast. So I think that's really amazing. And yeah, I do have to write scripts now, and I'm enjoying it. And it is a way to be more concise with sharing with you all. And I'm sure y'all were reading my script as I was talking about it. And I was basically testing it out so that way when I get ready for my next video, I have the script ready the way that I want, which I think is amazing. So scroll speed, I feel like between 15 and 20 is probably ideal, unless you want something faster. And if you're wanting to do something faster, you probably sound like somebody at an auction. So, you know, go at your pace when it comes to this particular feature. So to be conclusive with my video here, as we've done our demo time and we've went over each item on the prompter with the Stream Deck integration for Camera Hub, our video is coming to an end, and I wanted to thank you for watching, and I hope this has been helpful, not only to see the prompter in action and how it works and the different modes, and obviously there's going to be more features to be desired. I wanted to thank you for watching.